So now, students, we will move ahead in the next part of this chapter. So here, a new question, new type of question you have. Check the points 1, minus 1, 5, 2 and 9, 3 are collinear. So you have to check whether these three points are collinear. Collinear means they are in one line or not. This you have to check. Let's say this is the first point. Let's say this is the point 1 comma minus 1 and here you have another point 5 comma 2 and here you have another point that is 9 comma 3. Okay, let's say this is point P, this is point Q and this is point R. Now you check whether they are in one line or this point P is somewhere here. Okay, means you have to tell whether these three points are in single line or they are not in single line. If they are in single line, then you can say that these three points are collinear. Okay, collinear means they all the three points are in one line. Okay, right now I'm taking this point as 5, 2. Okay, right now this is the point P. Okay, now I have to check whether Q, P and R in one line or these are somewhere other in a plane. This you have to check here now. Now how will we check? Just look here. Same, we will use here the distance formula. So first we'll find out this distance PQ. Let's say point P is 5, 2, point Q is 1, -1 and point R is 9, 3. So first we will find out distance PQ. So distance PQ will be how much? Can you tell me? X2 minus X1, PQ. Let's say this is X2. This point is Y2. This point is X1 and this point is Y1. So X2 minus X1 means 5 minus 1 whole square plus Y2 minus Y1 means 2 minus 1. So it will become plus 1 whole square. So from here, value of PQ you can get square root of 5 minus 1 is 4. 5 minus 1 is 4. Square of 4 is 16. Same way 2 plus 1 is 3. Square of 3 is 9. Is it clear? 2 plus 1 3 and square of 3 is 9. So from here value of PQ will be square root of 25 and 25 is the square root of 25 is 5. Okay. So value of PQ means this distance you have got PQ as 5 unit. Now same way we will find out PR. Now we will find out PR. So this is X2, Y2 and now this will become X1 and Y1. Same way it will be square root of X2 minus X1 means 5 minus 9 whole square plus y2 minus y means 2 minus 3 whole square. So value of PR from here will be 5 minus 9 is minus 4. Minus 4 square is plus 16. Square of minus is plus. Okay. 16. Same way here 5 minus 9 is minus 4 square 16. Here 2 minus 3 will be how much? Can you tell me 2 minus 3? This is 3 or 5, I think this is 5. I have written it wrong. Write it 5. Oh, okay. Now let's say it is 3 right now. We have to check whether these three points are collinear or not. No? Let's say it is 3 now. Okay. So now 2 minus 3. 2 minus 3 will be how much? 2 minus 3 is minus 1. And square of minus 1 is plus 1. So from here value of PR is square root of 17. Value of PR. Now we will find out QR means this complete distance. QR. Now we will find out QR. Visible or not? Good. Now we will find out QR. This complete distance from here to here. So now for finding out QR, this point we will take as x2, y2 and this point we will take as x1, y1. x2, y2, x1, y1. Now we have to find out QR. So for finding out QR, एक्स टू माइनस एक्स वन होल स्क्वायर मीन्स वन माइनस नाइन, वन माइनस नाइन होल स्क्वायर प्लस माइनस वन माइनस थ्री होल स्क्वायर. सो इट विल बिकम क्यू आर इक्वल्स टू वन माइनस नाइन इज माइनस एट, माइनस एट स्क्वायर इज सिक्सटी फोर प्लस सिक्सटी फोर. सिमिलरली माइनस वन माइनस थ्री माइनस फोर स्क्वायर इज सिक्सटीन. गेटिंग दिस? सो फ्रॉम हियर वैल्यू ऑफ क्यू आर विल बी स्क्वायर रूट ऑफ सिक्स प्लस फोर टेन, जीरो कैरी वन, सिक्स प्लस वन सेवन, सेवन प्लस वन एट, स्क्वायर रूट ऑफ एटी. इफ यू विल फैक्टराइज इट, इट विल बिकम हाउ मच? ट्वेंटी फोर जा सिक्सटी, ट्वेंटी फोर जा एटी, सॉरी ट्वेंटी फोर जा एटी. सो इट विल बी, जस्ट फैक्टराइज इट, फैक्टराइज एटी, टू फोर्टी, टू ट्वेंटी, टू टेन, ओके टू फाइव. सो इट विल बी फोर रूट फाइव, फोर रूट फाइव. सो यू कैन राइट इट एज फोर रूट फाइव. ओके, नाउ लुक हियर. नाउ इफ दीज थ्री पॉइंट्स आर कोलिनियर देन दिस प्लस दिस शुड बी इक्वल्स टू दिस कंप्लीट. यस ऑर नॉट? इफ दीज थ्री पॉइंट्स आर कोलिनियर देन पी क्यू प्लस पी आर शुड बी इक्वल्स टू क्यू आर. ओके, नाउ हियर यू टेक फॉर पी क्यू आर टू बी कोलिनियर, फॉर पी क्यू आर टू बी कोलिनियर. नाउ वैल्यू ऑफ, सो पॉइंट पी एंड क्यू एंड आर विल बी इन वन लाइन, विल बी कोलिनियर इफ, इफ व्हाट? पी क्यू प्लस पी आर इज इक्वल्स टू क्यू आर. नाउ इज इट देयर हैपनिंग? जस्ट लुक एट वैल्यू ऑफ पी क्यू इज फाइव, वैल्यू ऑफ पी आर इज हाउ मच? अंडर रूट सेवनटीन. एंड वैल्यू ऑफ क्यू आर, क्यू आर इज हाउ मच? फोर अंडर रूट फाइव. आर दे इक्वल? 5 प्लस अंडर रूट 17, कैन इट बिकम 4 अंडर रूट 5? नो, नॉट पॉसिबल. सो यू कैन से नॉट इक्वल्स. हेंस पी एंड क्यू आर आर नॉट कोलिनियर, नॉट कोलिनियर. हेंस यू राइट, हेंस पी कॉमा क्यू कॉमा आर आर नॉट कोलिनियर. मीन्स दीज थ्री पॉइंट्स आर नॉट कोलिनियर, मीन्स दे आर नॉट इन वन लाइन. सो इफ दीज थ्री पॉइंट्स आर नॉट कोलिनियर, दे विल मेक अ ट्रायंगल. एनी थ्री पॉइंट्स, any three point, one point here, another point here, another point here, these three points are not in not collinear. So it mean what they will make? They will make a triangle. Yes or not? If the three points are not collinear, remember this always, if the three points, I am talking about the three points because the triangle is made up of three points. Okay, now if the three points are not collinear, then they will sure they will make a triangle. So you can write, hence P, comma Q, comma R makes a triangle. They will make a triangle. They will not make a straight line. If they are collinear, then they will make a straight line. If not collinear, then they will make a triangle. Is it clear? Very good. Now I am just changing this question. First you note it down. Now if you have noted, then I will just see what is the change I am going to do right now. Okay, first you note it down. If you have noted, let me erase it from here now. Now what I am going to do, just look here. Let's say this is the point P, this is the point Q, this is the point, sorry, P, Q, and this is R. Now this point is, earlier I have make right written is at 3. Now I'm just changing it. Let's say this is 5. Let's say this is the point 5. Okay. 9 comma 5. Okay. 1 comma minus 1 and this is. Okay. Now again I'm checking whether these three points, my 1 comma minus 1, 5 comma 2 and 9 comma 5 are collinear or not. Now I have to check whether these three points are collinear or not. Okay, so same way, first I will find out PQ. PQ I have already found. Now I'll find PR. What will be PR? Just look here. PR. Look here. Let's say this is x2, y2 and this is x1, y1. So 5 minus 9 whole square plus y2 minus y1 means 2 minus 5 whole square. 2 minus 5 whole square. So from here you can get PR is equals to 5 minus 9 will be how much? Minus 4 and square of minus 4 is 16. Similarly, 2 minus 5 is minus 3, square of minus 3 is 9. So it will become how much? Under root 25 and square root of 25 is 5. So value of PR is also 5 now. This is also 5 and this is also 5 now. Now what I will find? I will find out QR. QR. This complete distance I am finding out. Let's say this is the point x2, y2 and this is x1, y1. Now I will find out QR. QR. Square root of 1 minus 9. Whole square plus minus 1 minus 5. Whole square. So from here QR will be equals to 1 minus 9 is minus 8. Square of minus 8 is 64. Similarly, minus 1 minus 5 is minus 6. Minus 6 square of minus 6 is 36. So from here, QR will be 36 plus 64 will be under root 100. And from here, you can write QR as 10. Okay? Because square root of 100 is 10. Now, look here. For P, Q, R to be collinear. You can write it PQ, P, Q, R will be, I'm writing it, will be collinear if PQ plus PR is equals to complete QR. Is it happening here? Just look at PQ is how much? 5. Plus PR is how much? This is also 5. QR is how much? 10. Now here you can see 5 plus 5 is 10 and 10 equals to 10. Yes, both are same. Hence, P and Q are collinear. Hence, you write here. Hence, P, Q, R are collinear. So, if these three points are collinear, what they will make? They will make a triangle? No. Only non-collinear points are making triangle. So, they will make what? They will make a straight line. Hence, they will make a straight line. You can write it. Hence, these three points will make a straight line. Are you getting this? So, these two sort of questions we have done today. So, in the next video, some other type of question we will discuss. Okay then, see you.